What an incredible day of games so far. Welcome back to the Rumble stage of MSI 2021. I'm still Dracos, that's still Cadron. We're gearing up for game five of the day between PSG Talon and, of course, on the opposite side, Pentanet GG. Monumental day for Pentanet. Yes, they started with a loss, but a single win on this stage would be an incredible, incredible victory for their region. We'll see if PSG can take it away from them.
Well, we're straight into draft. Let's see if they can indeed. So Renekton banned away again, Lee Sin banned away. Nidalee taken off the board, interesting ban away there, but Pabu has played twice here at MSI. He's played a lot of champions here at MSI, but we'll see how the draft phase progresses, because we've still got things like Morgana, still got things like Rumble Open, and we've still got things like the Thresh Senna, which actually haven't been picked too much, but seem very, very strong.
Remain highly banned, at least, certainly, and we'll see what the priority looks like as a lot of the champions remaining. There's actually just a lot of very powerful champions remaining in general. They've taken away Biopanther's Urgot. That has been his most successful pick so far in the tournament. Makes sense when Hanabi is often a guy that spends a lot of time alone on an island. Limit some of the strong picks for his opposition.
Yeah, a lot of things they're banning away here are just target bans, right? The Urgot from Biopanther, the Nidalee from Pabu, and the Lee Sin away from Chaz, who's played that. This is his most played champion at MSI so far. So ban away on the Gnar for the last ban on the side of Pentanet. So there's a lot of OPs you'd argue open, right? The Senna, the Thresh, all the junglers are up, and Tristana. So we'll see what the priorities are. And if they want to first pick something like the Senna, then you've still got jungle options in the Rumble or the Morgana, whichever one Pentanet don't decide to take away.
And there are so many power picks available, Udyr being one of them. Yep. Seems to be the new SS tier in terms of a thing, the one above S tier, the S plus. Because while Morgana and Rumble were certainly the hype before the tournament, this is the third or the second game in a row now where we have seen all three of those junglers up and available, and Udyr remains the first pick.
Yeah, first pick coming in. And again, Pentanet, similar to Cloud9, they don't have to pick their jungler on the 1-2 because they can pick it on the 3 as a response. They could secure something like the Kai'Sa Nautilus on the 1-2. Maybe something like a Kai'Sa Tristana could work as well. But they are instead going to just pick up their jungler. Save third pick for the support. Maybe they just want to get a counter pick in. If the enemy team blinds Thresh, we can go Nautilus. If they blind Nautilus, we can go for something like maybe the Rell or the Leona instead. But if they do lock in this Thresh, which I expect PSG will, then there is definitely the option to just go for that Nautilus on 3.
Very likely now that we see no Senna in this draft whatsoever, a question will be what hyper carry do PSG want to pair with this Thresh? They can risk going to the next ban phase and see what just gets taken away before making their selection.
Yeah, Philios, I was about to say, it makes the most sense with the Thresh. Mobile AD carry gets the Lantern to take him out of dangerous situations and one of the biggest hyper carries on the patch right now, alongside things like Tristana, arguably Kai'Sa, and Jinx. So I expect that one to get locked in, and then just see what Pentanet's response is. I would expect it to be something like a Nautilus, and then let solo lanes go 4-5, because you're red side, you can get counter pick on mid or top on that last pick and first choice of solo lane on the 4.
Debating though, taking their time here. I do love the Aphelios lock-in for Doggo. I love this bottom lane in general. From a fandom perspective, from a meta perspective, I think it's solid. It does what it's supposed to. We'll see how well it works for them as the game progresses. This is where we really get to see how deep Pentanet want to go into their champion pools. They were players who were not afraid to innovate, not afraid to take out very powerful solo queue picks, but for now it will be the Nautilus, as expected. Strong bottom lane, strong jungle, leaving those solo lanes for later in the draft.
Maybe they want to run something like the Zed back again. They have the Morgana jungle, so they have the AP to back it up. They could opt into double AD solo laners, but Lucian, Renekton, Gnar being banned away only really leaves you that Tristana or Zed mid. There will be a lot of top lane options open. Things like the Jace are still available for that top side of the map. But now it's all down to whether they want to blind pick their top laner or their mid laner. Jace away, Gnar's been taken away, Renekton's been taken away, Urgot has been taken away, and Lee Sin as well. So arguably 5 kind of bans here on the top side of the map. If you count things like the Lucian, it's a 6 ban. And we'll have to see what the blind pick for Pentanet will be. Maybe they can opt into some kind of weak side top, or things like Set might be very strong, or GP.
Well, and interesting to see that they've opted to ban out the top laners here, because last time, obviously, up against Denwon, we saw multiple mid lane bans, targeted Maple, things like the Zoe, things like the Morgana taken off the board, taken out of his hands. Do we see something like that limited, or are they going to give Maple free access to maybe a comfort control mage pick? Orianna would be strong in the context of a composition that could potentially rely on Aphelios for damage output. That said, do love the Nocturne ban, limiting some of those strong topside talkside ticks, as now again, the set comes in. Maple does have one game on this. I didn't love it in the overall scheme of things. Think it would be pretty weak with an Udyr jungle in terms of raw damage output, but certainly very powerful in the early to mid game.
Yeah, so many top lane bans here as well. There's the Qiyana ban away from Pentanet. Maybe they're scared of Chaz running that one back. He did play one game of Qiyana, did solo kill crying in that RNG game. And I think a weak side top like a Sion makes the most sense, unless you want to opt in something like the GP. I think a blind pick Sion into a last pick, perhaps AD or scaling mage mid, are probably the best options Pentanet have here. But then again, Hanabi has got counters to Sion, you'd expect, despite the amount of bans on top side.
Well, With the Gnar, the Lucian, and the Renekton now taken away, counterpicking Sion is quite difficult. Of course, he could just look to match the scaling on the top side with something like the Ornn, go even, and then see you can out-impact in the team fights. This would be bold.
Yeah, the only real options he has here for counters, in a sense, are things like the Camille, maybe if he wants to opt into it. But I expect maybe, yeah, you're right, if they just opt into the Ornn. But the thing is, the enemy team has Morgana, right? So Ornn into Morgana is not the nicest of matchups. There's an Aatrox,
okay,
which
there you are.
I completely forgot about. Aatrox into Sion, notorious counter there for the side of PSG. So despite having like 6 or 7 top lane bans, they still have a really good top matchup. It's all down to what they want to blind pick mid. And you hit it, Dracos. The Zoe for Maple might be coming in, as I say that.
Some options, some flexibility, though. Could go for the more utility-focused pick of the Twisted Fate. But Urgot, stock standard control mage mid lane, maybe what we're used to seeing. I like Maple on more aggressive, more assassin-focused picks. That said, he was kind of just the Azir King domestically, but it will be the Sylas. Some decent alts to take away. Sion alt scales very well with AP, with Stolen, Morgana alts, similar story, Nautilus, Kai'Sa, all across the board not looking bad. It's not an Alistar, but some good selection here for Maple.
Yeah, that's the cool thing about the Sylas in the current meta, whether it's Gnar top and a Gnar ult, or things like the Nocturne, the Morgana, the Nautilus, such nice ultimates coming out from loads of the champs in the current meta. So are we going to see the Zed? We talked about it in the first phase of the draft. You've got an AP jungler. It's not the worst pick. And as they like to say, they are going to send it for the Zed pick. I like the balls on this team, but the problem is Zed into Sylas doesn't sound like the easiest of matchups.
No.
But you never know. Maybe he gets a solo bottle.
Maybe he finds the opportunity to go for the solo kill. Black Shield could help if it's going to be the 2v2. But we'll keep our eyes on that mid lane. Top lane is probably would be an island. We'll see if that's the approach. Can Hanabi build a big individual advantage? But across the board, we are set for some pretty explosive early laning phases, and I love the Pentanet at every stage of this tournament have been willing to draft crazy stuff into their opposition.
But that's what brought them success. These kind of, not cheese picks, but different off-meta picks is what got them out of round one, I think, when they pick things like the Zed and the Karthus and the Nidalee jungle. These almost like non-centric meta picks has just helped them a lot. Qiyana, Ahri, Rumble mid, all these crazy picks. Even Kassadin earlier today we saw from the side of Pentanet, and they don't want to pick standard champs because maybe they think that if they pick a standard baseline comp in the meta against a stronger opposition, then they're just bound to lose. So let's throw a curveball in there and let's pick something different. And now we get the Zed from Chaz again.
I love it. And even better, now we get to see what Maple's version of Sylas looks like. Showmaker put on a clinic when this team played against Down 1 earlier in the day. It was absolute devastation. Maple said, hey, I like the look of that. I'll pick it up. I'll try my hand on it. What can Maple do on the Sylas up against the side of Pentanet? Something we're going to keep our eye on as we get ready for this game. And Kadril, as we have the moment of silence, as we have the pause before we get in the game, let's talk a little bit about regional rivalries. Now, Southeast Asia and OS, not something that you'd always consider a rivalry. And I'm not trying to sell it as one, but what I will say is that a certain team knocked Legacy out 3-0 in last year's play-ins.
Who was it?
Well, it might have been PSG Talon.
It might have been PSG to qualify to the group stage of Worlds. Yeah, so not a great track record against PSG for the LCO. Maybe Pentanet can change that up, though, because I think Pentanet, just in this round two, I don't think anyone expects him to get out. But if PSG want to stand a chance of getting out in the top four in these six teams, dropping a game to Pentanet would be horrendous for them.
Absolutely would be. And I think that's something that's important to remember, that Pentanet, they're not expected to make it out of this group, but they can decide who makes it out. A single win, a single upset could upset everything for everyone else. So something that we're keeping our eyes on now. That said, let's take a look at what we can expect here in the early game. Morgana versus Udyr. Get used to seeing it. We're probably going to see it every game that it's not banned, as Rumble seems to have dropped a little bit here in priority.
Udyr, Morgana, Rumble. That's what we're going to be seeing all throughout the day, because if you want to get rid of one of them, you have to invest 3 red side bans to do it, and it just ain't worth it. So Pabu actually has Dark Harvest on this Morgana. Didn't opt into Predator, so maybe he wants to farm up, go for those full AP items, just do more damage in teamfight to the Dark Harvest. Early ward on his top side entrance towards the Raptors to make sure he doesn't get invaded on, because Morgana level 1 is quite weak. And last time we saw Morgana jungle was Blabber, and he was doing Red and Raptors at the same time. We'll see if Pabu does the exact same thing. 2 camps at the price of 1 while healing up off of both. But mid matchup is going to be explosive, you'd expect, when Chaz hits level 6.
Yep, and Hanabi in the meantime has gone for the leash and will head to top side. So they're going to have general information on where River has started. The early leash will help him match the double clamp clear speed that Morgana can bring to the table. But Biopanther doing his best to just tank the wave here, push it in as much as he can. Obviously, this matchup is going to get much harder the later we go.
Yeah, definitely. Sion can't really out-damage the Aatrox healing later on into the game. will need some jungle assistance, but Pabu did do the Red Raptors together and he's moving towards the Krugs. So he's pathing bot side and River's pathing bot side too. So it all comes down to bot prio. Can Praedith and Decoy get the push in to help Pabu get that early Scuttle Crab? And Praedith is a player who's been such a staple for Pentanet in their wins. He's helped them out so much on things like the Samira pick. You'd remember that he's doing so much damage, almost 30% of his team's damage on these picks. The Zaya also stands out to me as one of those staple carries that he's played throughout the tournament. And he was so crucial in their wins because he was the consistent driving force behind this team in the later stages of the game.
And we heard that from the team as well coming into the tournament. That's obviously the player that you need to watch. You need to watch Praedith. Now, important to note, that is just stats and wins. If Praedith starts to fall behind here, it is still difficult now. But if Pentanet, of course, want to win, usually it's through investing resources in Praedith. It's getting this man ahead, getting this man on a hyper carry, having a Kai'Sa with the exhaust already to leap into backlines whenever he wants to. Certainly seems to be a strong start from Picks and Bans.
Yeah, and he has the picks around him to help him. You've got the frontline Sion, you've got the Black Shield, Zed's buying a lot of time in the backline with a Nautilus to help you engage. So eyes on Praedith as the game progresses. But in this early stages of the bot lane, looks like they're just losing out on the trades. River's here first, so he's cleared faster than Pabu. He should be able to pick up this bot scuttle with Smite as Pabu doesn't have it. And Pentanet respect it. They don't want to get caught out on this wave that's slow pushing into them, because if they lose their flashes, they could be at risk of getting dove, or if they get chunked out too much, they're going to lose the wave.
This is a little bit of a snowball factor, honestly, of getting a leash in the early game. It's only a 3-4 second difference, but you can see Udyr there before Morgana can even clear a camp. It's solid to have. Now Pabu forced to move up to the top side just to make sure he does not get double scuttled here.
Yeah, and River's looking mid. Chaz just used W to push out the lane. Maple eased the creep to gap close, and now Chaz no dash.
Again.
Pabu's there, though.
Black Shield there to protect his mid laner, but of course no other cooldowns because he's focused on the Crab. It will be a Crab for Crab trade as both junglers will move up to about 28 CS. Pabu though now just in time to re-catch the Raptors here.
Yeah, and important to note, Maple has TP in this lane, so he can afford to trade aggressively and get Chaz's potions and then TP back. But he's hasn't forced any just yet, and this bot lane looks pretty rough for Pentanet as the hook goes wide. Decoy almost cracks the lantern and looks for Doggo there.
Close, but ultimately no cigar. Felly's with the small lead here. Of course, he's about to swap guns. Starts with green and red. We'll swap over to purple, blue momentarily. We'll allow for better pressure in the wave with that blue gun. It's Chaz not really coming out on top in that trade, but the other thing to note, while TP will certainly allow Maple to take health trades, mana is something that he has to watch out for, Chaz, as an energy champion. It's a simple point, but it is something to consider the longer the lane phase goes.
Pabu up towards his top side. He hasn't based yet. He did his two top camp respawns. That's why he's on 36 creeps, whereas River actually based and went to the top side. So a little bit slower on these wolves, but when he finishes them, he'll be level 5 as well, you'd expect. And then he can start impacting the map while Pabu has to base. So, River, what can he do with this? Can he slow down Chaz's base to help out Maple? That would be a very big factor in terms of helping him in the lane phase. You can see Dragon's up as well, so he has a lot of options, but there's no top camps for him to take. And Maple freeing him up would be a very important thing for the side of PSG here, because he's one of their staple carries, I think. Yes, we did see him on things like the set in the first day of the MSI round one, but that's not what we want to see from Maple. We want to see things like the Azir, these kind of Zoes, Lucians. He's been playing it all. This man's played almost a different champion every single game. This is his second game of Sylas regardless, though, but he's the man you're looking at for the side of PSG to get them through these games.
And Maple, a name that everyone should know from the days on the Flash Wolves to his stint in the LPL, now back in the PCS with PSG. This is a guy who I think you're always going to have some expectation of just because of the massive reputation that follows him. That said, as you mentioned, it's been a bit hit or miss. The set mid, not really a great start here on the Sylas, though he has all the tools that he needs to really get things kicked off. We'll see if he and River can get this team rolling. River, naturally a guy that we're going to look towards in this early game alongside Pabu, is in the top lane, as expected. A little bit Aatrox favored here, at least, when he can cancel out that Q whenever he wants.
Yeah, a lot of contesting around this bot side vision, though, so we'll keep our eyes on top side because Aatrox should outscale, but it might be a fight
flash
here.
Flash forward, Kaiwing hits the hook. That should be all too easy. Decoy going to get taken down, and the stolen Nautilus ult is there as well if they want to commit. TP coming in, but Biopanther has no room to maneuver. The follow-up as Chaz goes over the wall. The instant CC comes in from the Aphelios. Biopanther not even able to channel the Q in the end. Maybe he can kill the wave with the zombie mode, but he can't even get that. Maple is here to fight him. And the creeps are going to push in uncontested.
Huge engage from Kaiwing. All of that contest was about vision. 4v4 for the bot side vision to start up the Drake. And then PSG are the ones to pull the trigger first. Decoy gets caught out by the hook that he doesn't respect. Doesn't flash away from it. Dies instantly. And Biopanther was already channeling his TP as Decoy got hooked. So he goes into the fight and dies as well. The Sion ult back to top wave to catch it. Hanabi picks up a kill. And PSG get themselves off to an early gold lead.
Excellent, excellent start for PSG. About 1,500 in their favor. Now Papu's going to take away a couple camps on this back one, try to get something back. Keep in mind it is a level 6 Udyr here, however. Chaz just hovering in the area to make sure that he can cover.
Does he have time to do this? It looks like he's starting him up. But we'll take a look at this replay. All about vision. River just cleared away a ward, and the ping comes in from Pentanet. Flash hook, almost blind, but he saw him walk into the bush, so he does connect it. And then from there, the TP's already channeling as soon as the hook hit in the first place, so Biofan is forced to flash away. The Nautilus ult that was stolen away, like you said, follows him through. Two quick kills for the side of PSG, and Chaz almost picked up River with his ultimate, but didn't have the damage in the end.
Really, just solid overall from PSG. I think very bold to flash, go for the flash hook there.
Yeah, it looks like River took away that blue. So before the replay started, Pabu started up the Gromp on the blue. I think River was in time to take that blue away. Pabu doesn't get that. And because Pabu was on the top side of the map, River takes his camps, runs towards the bot side, skips his wolves. Bot lane has a good way for a dive. They might look for some kind of 4v2 dive here. No TPs to work with on the side of Pentanet.
And we talked about it. When Pentanet win, Praedith is set up for success. But now Praedith is the one getting focused. Maybe ready to leap in. Doesn't have an ultimate, but doesn't need it. In a few more seconds, he'll be able to take something away. Doggo now stepping forward. He's turning, he's spinning. They're Shurikens across the board. They're just getting shredded. There's no room to maneuver. Decoy tanking so much damage. River going to hold on to the tower aggro, and it's flawless from PSG.
Absolutely flawless, like you said. What a great dive from the side of PSG. They see Pabu towards the top side, and River just skips his bot cams, runs straight down. Bot lane stacking a wave. Maple has the mid push. All the stars align, and look at this Aphelios melting through this bot tower. 8 minutes in the game, there's only one plating left with that white gun, just shreds it through. Yes, Chaz will get almost two plates in response, but they're cracking this game wide open, Dracos.
And Maple giving it a thumbs up. We take a look at this again, the flawless trade of tower aggro coming in here from the side of PSG as they just make this look easy.
Yeah, look at the execution as well. Both stacking, they get the CC layered, River tanks up the tower, doesn't drop it just yet, drops it last second, one tower shot hits Doggo. Perfect dive from the side of PSG.
And on top of that, you already mentioned it has the Chakram, so it just shreds through, gets a few more plates. Now, PGG are going to be able to get the Infernal Drake back. That's a good start, but you can see across the rest of the map, things are looking difficult. Maple instantly stacks Conqueror, almost immediately kills Chaz, and this is going to be rough.
Yeah, misses the Q, but he's not maxing Q, so that wouldn't have to change too much in this exchange, but he's definitely winning this mid-matchup. Takes away the Zed ult. He can E-Flash R this guy if he wants to take him down. Chaz would have to respond with the ultimate himself.
I gotta be honest, I feel for Chaz.
Yep.
This man came up playing against Westor, one of the historic all-time great Zeds. He, if anyone is gonna smash you in this matchup, it's gonna be Maple. Holding, waiting for cooldowns. Ulti comes out. If he ults second, though, he wins. But no, Chaz leaps away, burning, ticking, down. Not quite enough damage.
Almost had him. If he had Q up, he probably would have taken him down there. Maple could have responded with the flash, but Chaz, really good combo there with the Electrocute, almost took down Maple. Maple didn't even hesitate, didn't flash, didn't ult. Hook hits Praedith, though.
Over the wall for Praedith. They immediately fall out. Aphelios, red and white guns on top of it. Again, insult to injury. PSG just dominating.
Yeah, PSG control the vision. They can't really walk in their own jungle at this point. River's there. The hooks connect from Kaiwing. Decoy can't even get to bot tower. Chaz is losing waves mid, and now this bot tier one you'd expect is probably going to fall from the side of Doggo. He's going to be able to take that one down. Almost 10 minutes in the game, if you're losing your bot tier 1 and you haven't even used Herald yet on the side of PSG, you're going to lose even more in this early game.
And while it was a bit scrappy and a bit back and forth up against Mad Lions, Mad may have always held the gold lead, but you know, Pentanet was finding blows. In this game, it is nothing. They have gotten a dragon, they have gotten literally nothing else. It is 5-0 and a tower, a 4k gold lead in favor of Paris Saint-Germain Talon. This is an unstoppable performance.
Yeah, we'll call that Mad Lions game a little bit of a happy game from them getting caught out here and there, but Maple's going for the dive.
Ulti goes in, follow up with the stun, can just go right back out. Ticking, but not quite enough damage.
Chaz has to base again. He's going to lose another mid wave, and River could run mid and pop the Herald here because they have a good window, but because of the bot push and support and base, I don't think he's going to do that. And quietly on the top side, Hanabi is just farming up. He's a level up on Biopanther, has that kill from the early stages, so there's no real winning lanes here for the side of Pentanet. Their bot's getting the push, but they're behind. Chaz is losing the mid trades. Biopanther's going to get outscaled. Pabu needs to find some kind of play.
And again, we're seeing a similar game to last game where the Morgana can get very far ahead in CS, but very hard for her to make the plays. 0-0-0, the score for Pabu. River on the opposite side, 0-0-4. This man on a tear, absolutely everywhere on the map.
Yeah, definitely similar to last game, because Pabu is actually up a level on River and up in CS, but River's found four plays on the map, has picked up the Herald as well, while Pabu's only really found the Dragon, so he hasn't found many plays yet. Hovering around mid, River has the Herald as well. It's all about bot side vision here. If PSG just leave top to farm, they're already winning on that side of the map. So let's play towards the bot side. This Aphelios is fed. We can push in bot tier 1, move towards mid. Four members strong, and they have the Herald to work with. Pentanet need to respond. You can see Praedith running mid and losing out on bot waves here.
Pabu in trouble. If they can break the black shield before the stun comes out, it's not going to matter too much. The ulti going forward. Pabu trying to turn this one back. Good damage down, but Maple healing it all. Pabu just... barely able to flash over the wall. Here's Chaz walking away from that one. Oh. Ophelios gets the follow-up from downtown with the mark. Prayed it. Can he turn it back? He doesn't have the damage. Doggo's too strong. He swaps guns with the flawless time, and it's too easy. Spin, spin, spin. Prayed is running for his life, but the follow-up is there again. Doggo is unmatched in these team fights. It is a double kill. All of PSG collapsing, and Pentanet cannot get a single kill.
It's almost an ace at 12 minutes in the game. They're going to lose their mid tower as well. Pentanet tried to fight back because they know if they don't do something, this mid tower will fall. Praedith tries to find the killer instinct onto someone there, I think, but doesn't actually have the range, ends up dying. Doggo has the Kraken Slayer in this fight at 10 minutes in. Now 12 minutes into the game after this mid tower falls and the fight ends. Yeah, Pentanet really don't have much to work with at this point.
9 for 9 on kill participation from Doggo. The substitute for this lineup, the man that had to sub in to play for this team on an international stage, really stepping up in this game and backed up, of course, by the team. But for PSG, after a rough first game, this is certainly the level of play that we want to see from them moving forward. They are the team that many expect to be on the outside looking in, sitting just behind a Cloud9 or a Mad Lions in fifth place. That perception could change very rapidly if they keep having early games like this.
Yeah, no, and the early game against Damwon earlier today was actually really good as well. They almost had a 2,000-3,000 gold lead there, but you can just see Pentanet in this game, they have to defend the play. Prayed is dropping bot waves, they're moving mid. Biopanther TP's in. Pabu, yes, he does get caught at the start of the fight, but the hook from Kaiwing with the lantern just there on the Chaz forces him out of the fight. And then just keep your eyes on Prayed here. He tries to join the fight because he's the only real carry left after Chaz falls. He hits the killer, he hits the W passive onto Doggo, but look at the damage Doggo does. Prayed can't do anything. He's just kind of running forward, trying to find something. In the end, does decide to try and flash out. Doggo finishes him. 4 kills for PSG at 11 minutes in the game. Pentanet definitely struggling here.
Quick smile on the face of Maple. Obviously tough. Pentanet. See what they can do to come back in this game, but the sad B kind of explains everything that's happening, that you can't walk up. Even with two champions, you can't walk up to Doggo right now. He's just a very strong boy.
Can you even walk into your own jungle? River's gonna stop them taking away the Gromp, the thumbs up emotes flying around the Rift. Pentanet. Spirits are probably high in the comms, but the gold lead is very rough. As the Ocean Dragon's up, PSG is going to pick that one up. The only real objective for them after this is going to be that top tier one. And once all the tier ones are down, Pentanet are going to be pushed into their tier twos with no vision to work with. PSG in full control of this game.
And the thing that just makes it even harder is with an Ophelios on the team, they can shred through Baron very rapidly. It's very easy for them to extend this gold lead, but it feels... Wow. Okay, now whatever I was going to say is not as important as this gold chart. Look at Doggo, look at Maple. Massive, massive individual leads. The only strong point for PGG right now is Pabu. He's the one who's been benefiting from a lot of this farm. He has still a small lead over Udyr, but even now he's getting all of that taken away. Stolen, not of the salt goes in. They get the black shield out. Decoy does not want to commit for that one as both Maple and River will walk away.
Yeah, that ultimate was probably running out from Maple, so it doesn't hurt to just throw it out there, see what happens. In the end, gets black shielded, but the push in, bot taking away jungle, mid waves into tier two. PSG bot lane just moving towards the top side now. This top tier one's going to fall shortly afterwards. Yeah, Pentanet don't have too much wave clear. They have a decent amount of engage with the Nautilus, with the Zed, and with the Sion, but they don't have much wave clear. All short-range champions, barring the Morgana, and Biopanther, although he's a beefy boy, there's really not much he can do in response of this siege on the top tier one.
He can survive for now, as Doggo will shred through yet another tower.
Pentanet just keeping these three members strong towards the top side. They're making sure they stay grouped up. They don't want to fight a numbers disadvantage, but Pentanet's going in, trying to defend here.
Here we go, the flash over the wall, trying to lock him up. The turn right back from Maple, though. Chaz has to leap out to safety. It's Sanabi on the backside. All of Pentanet now zooming in. Praith wants to finish the job, wants to get something done, but still, PSG refused to go down. They still have not lost a single member. It's 11 kills to zero, 15 minutes into the game.
Yeah, and they have a mid wave too, so that mid tier two is going to fall as well. 15 minutes in, almost a 9,000 gold deficit for Pentanet. They try to defend their jungle. Maple lives. He gets away. PSG finds some more kills. And Pentanet, yeah, they're trying their best, but they have no resources to work with.
Outside of a single dragon, this has been a perfect game so far.
Yeah, it's
from
a rough Pentanet. One. It's a
or rough from
one.
PSG.
Yeah, as we see this one again, Pentanet, they just want to try and punish Maple here because he split. And we just said PSG need to fight with a numbers even or advantage. Maybe that's the only way they could find their way back in here in this new Axe Effect replay. And yeah, you can just see the goal and the damage that they have. It's just not there. They can't find Maple. Chaz is on the backside, level 9 against the level 11 Aatrox, a level 10 Ophelios. They're just way too far behind Dracos.
He's got two items. It's 16 minutes.
It's a rough one.
It's a rough one. And when this champion is even or behind, you have to like look at his guns and go, okay, is this the right time to get to go in? Is this the right time to find a fight? But when he's ahead, he just kind of, you can just mash the keyboard with whatever gun you've got and you kill everyone.
Yeah, especially with those items, almost three items on Doggo. 16 minutes in, Prayed is just finishing his Kraken Slayer. And at this point, PSG, it's all about taking Herald, cracking open the tier 2s, waiting for Baron, starting it on spawn, looking for a turn and ending the game. What can Pentanet realistically do? Well, you're down almost 10,000 gold. You have not much resource to work with. The only thing you can do is sack waves and look for number of energy. So that's why you see Praedus, Decoy, and Pabu all towards his top side. Maybe we can catch out Maple, get a kill, and then that leads into a top tier 1. And if we get that, maybe we can contest Herald. But that all has to come off the back of a mistake from PSG. Realistically, when you're this far down, you have to wait for the enemy team to make mistakes. You have to drop waves, and you have to force fights with numbers of energy. Just keep trying to find something.
Absolutely. And of course, if we get a chance to look at the XP, you can see just massive difference here as Maple pretty fearless on the leap in, but that's the exhaust, can just take that away. Waiting for the exhaust to timeout, will now leap in, Praedus in trouble, and that's just Silas things. He's so strong.
Yes, no damage, Praedus can't take him down even through the exhaust. Maple just heals through it with the shield, and now the Herald's popped. They might even be able to siege onto tier 3s here, but Diving School.
Can they get a single kill? Can they stop the otherwise perfect game? They got it! Chaz got one!
They're on the board. Pentanet's here, but there's still a Herald, and they're still going to lose this tier 3. I think Chaz might die. He has to ult to defend himself.
Oh, Chaz is just going to get burned down here. The TP now coming in on the Herald as well. It looks like PSG are ready to make this about the fastest game in the tournament we've seen so far. 17 minutes and counting. Hanabi grabbing another kill. But let that be a lesson to you, PSG. Nobody kills PGG 12 times in a row and gets away with it.
Yep, they do end up picking up a kill, but they lost their top in it. But 18 minutes, this is just a slaughter, you have to say. Pentanet, normally in these kind of games, Dracos, I would give you some way back that the losing team can find it. Maybe if you're down 4 or 5k gold, or if you have some kind of Drake win condition, or you have TP advantages, or you have a level up somewhere, or some gold lead on any lane, then there's a world where you can come back. But the problem is, Pentanet have nothing.
They've got spirit. They've got all the koalas behind them, but I am inclined to agree with you. I don't think that'll be enough as we check back on Maple's POV. Really love the play here. Just spamming W repeatedly
with the shield.
With the shield.
And he does have the Seeker, so he has a little bit of armor as well. But yeah, Praedus realistically doesn't have much damage. Just look at the items alone. Chaz is the only...
He didn't even have evolved Q at that point, so...
Yep. Well... It's just, now it all comes down to forcing fights. Pentanet just have to keep going in. They love to send it, just try again. If it doesn't work, keep trying. And even if you're going to lose these fights, finding something is the only way back. So you can see they're just trying to group and force a fight.
River is getting chunked down. River, will he fall? Another kill, Praedus on the backside. He's got enough damage to kill the Udyr. That's going to be one. Hanabi now trying to finish the job. That Aatrox is very powerful. Maypole is there as well. They're bullying Praedus in the fight. Biopanther, another name on the list. And meanwhile, Doggo's killing everybody else. This is this continues.
Yeah, but two kills, couple shutdowns for Pentanet. I don't think they're going to be able to run away here. The Aatrox kind of outheals both these tanks' damage, but Biopanther is going to try and get away.
Hook from downtown.
Kaiwing follows him. He has flash if he wants to go for it. There's Maple.
Now, trying to wrangle a Scion. They will find him. They will take him down. That is the ace. Flash Wolves, you love to see it. Good on you, Hanabi.
And Doggo was doing so much damage in the backline with his blue gun alongside Kaiwing. Chaz ended up killing him. Got a lot of gold on the shutdown, but look at your base. 20 minutes in, your Nexus towers are falling. And PSG are going to get a bot tier 2 after this play. Dragon is still up. They're probably going to pick that one up as well. And yeah, they're just so far ahead.
They're very far ahead.
Yep. And as we look at this replay, you can see Pentanet, they have to force. If you're in a losing game state like this, where it's beyond doomed, just try to force something and maybe catch them off guard. And they do kind of catch them off guard in a sense. River falls, Praedus trades his life one for one, but watch Doggo and Kaiwing. Chaz and Pabu versus the bot lane of PSG. Look at the damage, just melts through them, but they do have the damage to pick him up.
Wow.
With the death mark.
And he survives.
No, he doesn't.
Up until he dies.
Up until he dies. And then Hanabi's just way too much life steal.
Thank you.
Mix up the
Woo!
Kills.
Rough.
I got your back, dude. Don't
there
try.
You go. Speaking of rough, Doggo, very good boy this game. 9-1-8, about to take this Baron. Probably just about uncontested.
Just
maybe
started.
Pabu can take the Miracle Steal.
He has no flash, though, and he needs a Blast Cone. Hanabi's scouting out. Yeah, this Aphelios is going to melt through this Baron. And maybe Pentanet can look for a fight onto Hanabi, but then again, he has the flash, the ultimate, can probably lifesteal through it all. But Pentanet know that the second this Baron falls, their base is shortly going to fall after.
Wow.
But what a dominant game from PSG, though.
Yes!
Let's not take away from the fact that they are dominating this game, similar to the way RNG have done it, but they're doing also a clinic here as well. Very to little to none mistakes in this Red Bull Baron play here. Baron power play here, for the side of PSG. They're just going to siege onto these tier 1s. Not tier 3s.
And now Praedus is going to be in trouble again.
Yep.
Maple is on a murder spree. He's 6-0-7. I feel like this could be the end of the game.
Hanabi.
But there you talk about it. They wanted to commit everything onto Hanabi. They've knocked him up. They've started to take him down. They haven't procced Asterix yet, though. They haven't procced...
Oh, look at the life steal!
The healing's coming
from HP!
Oh, don't do it to him! Raid boss still up. They don't have the cooldowns, they don't have the gear, they don't have the levels. They're trying to go mythic and they have nothing. They're not even maxed.
Oh my lord, I think they can just kind of end it here. Doggo is here, Maple has a TP. Maybe he can TP in when the Nexus Towers start to get the creeps crashing on them. There it is, TP in. Baron buff on, 4 versus 5. Pentanet are gonna try their best to defend this, but PSG, Braedith gets one.
Goes in, finds a single kill. It's a 15k gold lead. It is an absolute slaughter. Pentanet routed completely and totally from start to finish in this game. It was a dominating victory coming in for PSG.
Yep. Great game there from the side of PSG. Pentanet tried their best. They kept forcing, and that's what you got to do when the game is losing that hard. It all came down to that mid-fight where PSG almost aced him at 11 minutes, where the game just kind of fed out of their control. And from there, PSG clean snowball. Not many mistakes at all, barring a few kills here and there. That was all Pentanet was able to pick up.
Yeah. PSG working on the any percent versus Pentanet.
Okay, dude, why you got to do him like that?
But for Pentanet, I mean, on the opposite side, for Pentanet, chance to recover. This was a very rough first day. They're going to have a few more days. They're going to have a few more opportunities. But today, they're not able to find a win. We'll see how they fare up against the likes of Cloud9, RNG, Damwon. It doesn't get easier.
It doesn't get easier. That's the problem.
It doesn't get easier. Hearts out to this team, obviously. Impressed that they made it this far. It's still such an incredible story for the LCO, for all of Oceania, regardless of how this game played out. And for the team, you hope that they can just show a better performance in a different game.
First time ever that the LCO has made it to the second stage of an international event, right? In group stage of a main event. They're finally here. They haven't shown up just yet. Their schedule only gets harder, but maybe they can go back to the drawing board, find some more innovation picks that help them pick up a few wins in these best of ones.
Yeah. But of course, speaking of wins, in this drive to victory presented by Mercedes-Benz, PSG's fight in the bot side river 11 minutes in. It was a veritable highlight reel. They spent the whole game driving to victory, but we take a look back at this one in particular. Fantastic look from the side of PSG.
Nice little camera angle. This is where Pabu gets caught out. Praedith, you can see him in the back there dropping bot waves to try and join the fight. Hook hits onto Chaz, and this is where PSG clean house. They get 4 kills for none. Praedith tries to run in to take down Doggo, but he was just way too far ahead.
Oof. And I do love me some Ophelios highlights. Obviously, incredible finish here for him. Praedith, you can see that desperation just continues to come through, and Doggo gets to play cleanup while Maple and the rest of the team are just landing skill shot after skill shot. Biopanther.
Yeah. I think the game kind of fell out of PSG's control after that bot dive, right? Where they four-man dive bot, they got a double kill. Ophelios got 4 plates based, and he almost had a Kraken Slayer at 10 minutes. So, yeah.
It was
rough.
Yeah, it was no doubt it was rough. For Pentanet, we'll see how they can recover as we get further in the tournament. But after the break, we're going to hear from Maple before it's time for the NA versus EU clash. Ooh. Vote of 4 as Mad Lions and Cloud9 take to the stage. Woo.
The magical power of the realm is a mystery. Like a guardian, it is with you always. Defending you, charging you, watching over you like... Actually, it's not magic. It's this Cisco network. The power behind every gank, every combo, every mind-blowing moment at League of Legends Esports, MSI 2021. We'll be right back.
Maple, thank you so much for joining me. Congrats on winning so convincingly against PGG today. Could you give me your take on why the game was so fast-paced and why you've been able to snowball so hard against them?
首先恭喜你们拿下了对阵 PGG 的比赛这场胜利嘛，可以跟我们说一下今天为什么节奏起得这么快，以及说雪球滚得这么顺利吗？
因为上一把打 DK 就是我们也是前期优势，但是我们节奏打太慢，然后不敢跟对方一直打，然后所以这把的话我们就修正这个问题，就想办法多打一点架。
So the last game when we faced off against Dongwon Kia, we got leads in the early game, but we didn't manage to dictate our tempo. So we played too slow in that game. And this game, we tried to play a more faster speed and pace in our game, try to have more team fights with the enemy team. That's the thing that we fix in our actual games today.
Indeed, you did speed up the pace in this game against PGG. I have a question for you about the meta, actually. What's your take on this Sylas pick and the matchup you had against Zed?
问一下关于这个版本的这个英雄选择上面的问题，你怎么看待萨拉斯打劫这样一个对线呢？
劫的话在对线上其实是不弱，但是他在打团的时候可能会比较有一些难度，所以对线的话，如果跟他发育的话，其实他打团就比较没用了。
So Zed is actually not a weak champion during the laning phase, but he seemed to not that useful in the team fight. So as long as you can pressure man during the laning phase, that it can be a more preferable way for Sylas.
Interesting. Well, thanks for these insights on that. I have a question for you about more the competition, because this is your return to the international stage. That's something we mentioned previously. But how fierce do you think is the competition since the last time you were here?
之前有提到过嘛，就是上次你的国际赛事，那这次你是重新回到了国际舞台，所以你觉得这一次的话会不会有什么不同呢？
这次的话我觉得我们
等一下，我说excuse me, it's about a difference?
Yeah, how different is the competition since the last time it was on the international stage?
对就是区别，你觉得什么不同？
就我觉得我们这次的话是更有机会拿到好的成绩的，所以就大家都在往这个，我们大家都在往这个方向努力。
I think for this time at international tournament, we have a bigger possibility to get better results than before. We're all fighting towards the same goal.
Yeah, and you had an amazing showing on your first day in the Rumble stage. Last question for you. We're about to go to the last game of the day. It's going to be Cloud9 versus Mad Lions. Any predictions on this matchup? Who do you think is going to win and why?
关于最后今天最后一场比赛的这样的一个预测，我们稍微聊一下，就是你觉得 C9 对阵到 Mad Lions 谁会赢呢？
我觉得应该是 Mad Lions 会赢，因为他们打赢了我们两次。
I think Mad Lions because they beat us for twice, right?
All right, well, we'll see about that in a few minutes. But Maple, thank you so much for the interview. Iris, thanks again for the translation, as always. And we're gonna take a break now, and we'll be back for NA versus EU Clash, Cloud9 versus Mad Lions in a couple minutes. Stay tuned.
Won this fight before it even started. This is an absolute slaughter. I don't think Pain Gaming have done a single point of damage.
This is a much different Mad Lions to last year. This is a Mad Lions to get excited about.
We are in League, one of the top teams. We have chance to be MSA champions.
Here we go, this is it.
In goes Vulcan, here comes Blabber. Fudge dives on, they got him behind. They shut down Ghost and they're looking for more. Blabber's gone down as well, but Showmaker is now dead and Sven has free reign to open up from villains to victors. C9 take down Dumb1.
We're gonna come in with the same fire and we're gonna fight and we're gonna try to win every game versus everyone.